everyone, welcome to iCorilla Designs event here. I hope you guys are doing great. I want to share a cute project that I created. It's actually a Christmas banner, so I'm jumping the gun here a little bit. I'm kind of going on the store bandwagon where Christmas is already out. It's a little crazy, but when it comes down to decorating the house for Christmas, I really, really enjoy myself and I go all out. So this year I figured I would start making all of my home decor items a little bit early. That way when December rolls along, I have all the stuff ready. So let me share what I've created. And like I said earlier, I created a cute little banner, and what I used to do this with, of course, since I am a designer for the Piece by Piece, I used the Piece by Piece trims, but I found these cool sample books. It's like fabric sample book, and basically that's what I made my banner out of. So let me show you what I've created. And here it is, you guys. It turned out beautifully. As you can see, I've used a lot of my trims and flowers from the Piece by Piece, and you can find them at thepiecebypiece.com, and I'll have a link down below. But let me get down to this beautiful creation that I made for Christmas here and show you what I did. So basically what I did is, out of my stash, I grabbed some chipboard lettering, as you can see here, and I used some of my Martha Stewart glitter for that. So what I did is I just took some clear adhesive and then glittered up these cute little letters, and they spell out the word joy. And here, let me show you. So as you can see, I've taken the sample piece. This is one of the sample pieces here, one of the fabric samples, and here's another one. None of them in the sample books really match, but they all match the same color family, which is a cute thing. So let me show you. All of these beautiful flowers you can get over at the Piece by Piece, and this is what I've done. I've taken two full flowers here, and then I've taken a flower and I cut it in half, and I created these half flowers here for the ends. And at the back, I just have jute for my camera to focus, and what I did is I have jute, and these are just basically where I'm going to hang my banner from. And over here in the centerpiece is what I did is I created out of this beautiful trim, as you can see here. Can you guys see that? And I think this is her French ribbon, if I'm not mistaken, or trim, because she has French trims that are like to die for, you guys, so you have to check it out. And I've taken that, and what I did is I just cut a I just punched out a little round piece, and I went ahead and I hot glued that around it to create a rosette. And then I used the Graphic 45 Fashionista paper to cut out this little scallop circle. And of course, you know I love to make pins, so I had to make the coolest little pin for that. And as you can see, and by the way, these little gold pieces here are so awesome. I got those when I went to visit the Dominican Republic, and they have like these bead shops with amazing stuff. Not to say we couldn't find that here, but I found those over there, and it was super cheap and super amazing stuff. So I have a bunch of stuff that I brought back, and it was a cool little find. And then of course a corsage pin right here. And for my corsage pin, it's a white corsage pin, and I took my Copic marker in E34, which is oriental, and I painted it down with that, so it looks really nice and pretty and beige to match my creation. I went ahead and I took another piece of trim, as you can see here, and what I did is I created this beautiful back piece. And I did the same thing. I cut out a circle and I added hot glue to it, hot glued around it, and created this piece here. And then of course the same ribbon that, I mean, trim that I just showed you there. Here I took a Tim Holtz die and I cut that out, and then I have a piece of Fashionista paper back here in a scallop circle, and then of course the O for joy. And then here I have this metal piece that says wish. And what I did there is, this comes in a different color, so I took the Krylon 18 karat gold leafing pen, and I went over that, and then I went over it with my finger so it looked tattered, and I added that there. I thought wish would be appropriate, so joy and wish. And then for my Y, I basically did the same thing, and I went ahead, and my camera's not really, there we go. And as you can see, I created a rosette down here again with the beautiful trim, my little scallop circle, the Y, and another pin. And I really like the way these pins turned out. So this is my little project that I'm coming to you with. Like I said, I'm just trying to get some of my projects done for Christmas kind of early, and I wanted to share this with you. Also, I want to mention that the Piece by Piece is holding a design team call, and I think that today is the day that it's going up. So if you go to the Piece by Piece, you can find them on Facebook and then on our blog and in different places. So I'll have the links down below for you guys. You can go and check it out. Yeah, so that is my video that I want to share with you, and my little project. Hope you guys enjoyed it. See you guys in a week or so. Bye.